This week, I don't have much to say because last week you saw the grief video. That's the reason I missed some points last week because of my rejection of my paper. Anyways, I'm past that moment. And actually last week, as I was speaking in week 8 or 9, I'll leave in the information card on the top right corner. So we had to do a collaboration with Zoid, that is the new, I mean, not new, it's the research center of the university, which is near our university. So I had the idea of building a mobile co-located collaboration tool, like a sensor which you can carry to different places, which is mobile, and that you can use for my research to detect when people work in a group, what are the indicators of collaboration. So the basic idea was that I'll give the idea and the people from Zoid will be working on that idea to build a prototype, initial prototype, by taking into account maybe only audio. So for that we had a brainstorming session last week in Brightlands campus of the Brightlands. It was a very nice place and with all the modern facilities that you need for research and teaching and all other stuff. And to me, the meeting was very productive and students started to think about it. So we had some discussions about what kind of devices we are going to use. And as I mentioned before, a big thank you to my colleague who initiated this idea, Marcel Smith from Zoid campus. And he is working as an external PhD at Open University with me and different colleagues. So he was the main pioneer of this idea, and then we kind of had some negotiation and some discussions and sort of. So it was a very productive, and I felt that the students are really interested. So initially, to keep it simple, they will only focus maybe on audio and maybe work with Google Home or Alexa, because that is the current device where you have the SDK in GitHub and you can work with different Alexa skills, like detecting the content of what you are speaking from the audio. So this is a small spoiler alert, and the duration of the project is like till the end of January. So I hope they will come up with a workable version of the prototype, and maybe then I will share with you like how can it help in my research and how can you collaborate with maybe a small scale partner, but still that will help you a lot if you find such collaborations, maybe on your own or maybe with someone else's help. That also makes it's very important to promote your research. And this week also you will like, we went to the Christmas in Valkenburg. We had it was raining, so maybe in future I'll go again if I get time and I'll have shoot a nice video, because this week it was raining and you might have already seen it because I posted like a month back a fast hyperlapse of the Valkenburg Christmas market, but it was raining, so it was very blurry and it was not that good. I mean, so, although I'm not an expert in photo making or video making, but still it was not good. So I will try to make another video. Maybe you'll also see that soon if I visit there again. But Valkenburg Christmas Market is really famous. Like, you should go there. It is famous, and it is a typical cave market in the underground caves, similar to the caves in Maastricht. They also have caves in Valkenburg, because this is very closer to each other, and maybe you can find some pictures. So that's it. So this week it was mostly continuing that discussion with the group in Zurich and working on my project, like how can I build, maybe like what is happening now is like kind of outsourcing or maybe collaboration with third parties like this. Like, suppose someone is doing a master thesis or someone from other university will build their project, and that will be part of my research. So it will be like my tool building or the prototype will be maybe built by 3-4 groups, or maybe 3-4 students who will also in turn gain a thesis. And I will maybe initially now focus on the feedback part, and then we can merge both the streams. So later, which will bloom into my PhD project. Also, one more thing is, I was very happy. I had discussions with my promoter and supervisors, and we finalized that probably in January, I'll be going for a journal to modify that work, which I submitted and which was rejected. I have many work on literature review. I will reshape it, give some finishing touches, and maybe in January after the vacation, in December, I will submit it for a journal with very good impact factor. We found one like that, maybe the potential one, but I don't know, like educational research review, which has a really high impact factor. Like, anything above 3 is considered really good, and that has like 4 point something, and it's really good. I mean, compared to the standard they use in Netherlands, which is really, really high, it's good in our field of research. So next week I'm going to collect my residence permit, and maybe you'll see some views of Maastricht. And yeah, you never know, you might see something. And also you'll be seeing the Sinterklaas party in our faculty, that is the technology enhanced learning group in where I walk. We'll see the Sinterklaas party, and that will be, trust me, believe me, that will be interesting and nice. So till the next week, peace.